Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is my first video and I'm super excited about it, so let's get straight into it. So I'm gonna talk about my favorite art supplies, my essentials, and what I use every day. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Marguerite. I'm a 21-year-old artist from Dallas, Texas, and I also go to university in Scotland. And I also paint mainly with acrylics and watercolor. So I do larger acrylic paintings and also smaller 4x6-inch watercolor paintings. So I'm gonna start with my favorite acrylic supplies. So the things that you need are a canvas of any size, whatever you like. You need some paints. You need brushes. You need paper towels, water, any cup that can hold water. It doesn't matter, just something for water, and a palette to mix. So first I'm gonna talk about the canvases that I use. So I always go to Joann's. For those of you who don't know what that is, that's a craft store. There's also Michael's, which has some similar things, or you can go to Blick Art, which is like an online website that has a whole lot of supplies. So I just go to Joann's and I get a value pack of canvases. I like to mix up my canvas sizes. So recently I've been doing a lot of these 10 by 10 squares. I've also been doing 12 by 16, more rectangular ones. And also my absolute favorites are these really huge 16 by 20 canvases, which are my favorite. I don't have any blank ones right now. So I just had to show you the one I just finished. But really any canvas, any size works great. As long as you're comfortable with the size. And I also really love to use the stretched canvas. These are these ones that have the wooden frame, as you can see, and it's kind of like a drum in the middle. And I just think a lot of people like to hang their canvases straight up on the wall. And I think the stretched canvases are so much easier to hang straight up on the wall, whereas the canvas panels, you really need to put into a frame if you're going to hang them. So I do the stretch canvases just because I think it's easier for customers to hang their paintings up where they want. So next I'm gonna talk about the acrylic paints that I use. So I use two different types of paints. I use the Liquitex Basics acrylic paints, and then I also use the Winsor & Newton Galleria acrylic paints, if you can see. I actually started out with the Winsor & Newton ones. My local craft store stopped selling them, so I switched to the Liquitex, but honestly, I like them both equally, and so I just get whatever one is available at the time. For me, they're both pretty similar. So I like both of them, and then I always get a giant tube of white, because white is the paint that I'm buying all the time. I run out of it all the time. It's like, I use it in every painting, so having a giant tube of white, you can see compared to my other tubes, my white is always the biggest tube that I have. So next I want to talk about the brushes I use. I use a variety of brushes. I use some of these I use these Low Cornell brushes, which are really great. These are these really long ones. I think longer brushes are really good for thinner lines, because you really have to like press lightly with them. So I've got these Low Cornell brushes, and then I also have these Princeton Art and Brush Co. brushes. I got a bunch of these Princeton Art and Brush Co. brushes, which are really great little detail brushes. And then I also got this pack of brushes on Amazon. It doesn't say what brand they are on them, and I don't remember what brand they are, but they're from Amazon. They're really great detail brushes. They're still pretty new, so that's why I still have them in a little plastic, but they go to really small sizes. So I really love this set I got from Amazon. I'll see if I can find it and link it below, but I love this. Also for acrylic paintings, always use lots of paper towels because I paint in my room. My room has carpet. I need a lot of paper towels so I don't get paint on the carpet. I always put a big towel down. So I work by my window in my room on the floor. I put a big towel down and then I put paper towels over the towel. So there's absolutely no spilling. I'm also kind of a careful person. I don't really spill very often. So if you're someone who spills a lot, you need lots of paper towels to protect yourself and your floor. And also paper towels so that you can clean your brushes in between colors. A lot of paper towels are great. So for part two, I also do watercolor painting along with my acrylic painting. And so I'm gonna talk about my favorite watercolor products. So I have been using this watercolor paper that I got a long, long time ago, and I've always been using the same brand, and I thought it was just fine. It was the watercolor paper I always used, and I forgot what brand it is now. But I recently ran out of that paper, and when I went to the craft store, they didn't have the same. So I ended up picking up this Daler Rowney is how I'll say it, watercolor paper. And honestly, it wasn't the brand I normally use. I didn't think I'd like it that much. I love this paper. This is not an ad. I really just absolutely love this paper. A lot of watercolor paper is off-white. This is still not quite white, but it's still really crisp. So I love the color. It also doesn't, like, I don't know how to describe it. Sometimes my watercolor paints on my other paper, they leak and they move around quite easily. Whereas with this, I think I get really, really crisp lines on my watercolors. They really are not leaking around, which is really great. So I highly recommend this Daler Rowney paper. And then coincidentally, I also use Daler Rowney watercolor paints. This is just Aquafine Daler Rowney. It's just a travel kit of watercolor paints that I just picked up because I was out and this is all I could find. Coincidentally, it is the same brand as the paper, but I love it. It's got all of these different colors. It's got this like palette to mix in the middle, and yeah. So Daler and Rowney, coincidentally, has become my to-go for all watercolor stuff. So if you are new to watercolor, I would pick up this Daler Rowney. This is what it's called. It's the Aquafine Texture Watercolor Paper. Then, so with my watercolors, I like to outline them in pen. So as you can see with this one, I've outlined it in pen. So these are my favorite pens right now. They're the Stadler? I think that's how you say it. I'm not quite sure. I'm just gonna say Stadler. The four pigment liner pens, there are six of them in here. And I absolutely love them. If any of you are wondering which ones I use the 0.2 one, which is kind of in the middle, towards the smaller side of the middle. But the 0.2 pen is my absolute favorite one for outlining my watercolors. So for any of you who are interested in my watercolor process, what I do is first I make a little sketch in pencil. Again, I just use whatever pencil. Then I always go over it with one of these pens, and then I go over with the watercolors. But that's just kind of my style, that's what I like. So those are all my favorite art supplies. If you have any questions, ask me in the comments. You can follow me on Instagram at Marguerite Knowles Art. And then you can check out my Etsy, which I'll link below, where I sell larger acrylic paintings. This doesn't even fit in the frame. But I sell larger acrylic paintings like this one. I also sell watercolor bookmarks like these guys. And I also sell lots and lots of small watercolor paintings. Frogs, flowers, that's upside down. But yeah, make sure to check out my my Instagram and my Etsy. And hopefully I'll make another video soon. But see y'all later, have a great day, afternoon, evening, week, month. Have a good time. Bye.